Hey everybody, how's it? This is Jeebs here, your old composer here at the Decomposer Lounge World Music. I want to thank you guys for hanging out. Last week going through and recycling through some of the bands and listening to your suggestions to listen more. I pick songs and go through, but this one's a brand new one. This one is by a band called Glass Animals, and the song is called Heat Waves. Apparently they are from England and they are kind of like an EDM pop band. So I want to thank those of you who suggested it, and well, there was one person that suggested it from my Patreon channel, so that kind of pushed me over the top. I was like, okay, I'm going to listen to this band. All right, so I want to thank you guys very much. Let's do this. Glass Animals from the album Dreamland, and this is called Heat Waves. All right, let's do this. All right.
Think about is you. Don't stop, baby, you can walk too. Don't want, but I think about you. You know that I'm never gonna lose.
You know, there's a couple of really nice things I want to bring up. First of all, with my experience with EDM and stuff as a media composer, especially as a library composer, one of the things that I have deep respect for in the genre is the ability to be really creative in the engineering aspect. That whole first 20 seconds is what I believe is called lo-fi. So that's when they take their arrangements and they actually treat it a particular way to give it that kind of really unique sounding, kind of squashed mono, you know, by pulling down tones in the EQ. It could be possible that they actually mixed that chunk and as a whole stem, that's what they call the export of a file, they would just take that and do the treatment to it by pulling down on the high ends, pulling downs in the, you know, pulling down in the mids or something, different ways to get that sound. But that was really nice because with EDM and stuff like that, as well as some of the metal stuff, actually, believe it or not, on my other channel that I have, using that is actually part of the toolbox of options that you know, musicians have. So we get into the arrangement and stuff, and it started really small, and they blew it up really big, a really fat in-your-face trap programming or drums, you know, the synth drum sounds, which is usually pretty predominant in EDM pop style. From what I understand, I'm not really that well versed. I mean, you guys straighten me out on that one. But what I really enjoyed about that, they have this really nice little kind of, it's a hybrid keyboard kind of tone that they're holding these, you know, I think it's four chords that they are repeating in their pattern. But I like how they opened up. I didn't know what to expect. The multiple harmonies and the vocals and stuff that were really spread out across our ears. When you listen to it in the headset, you can really hear that. And come to find that that was actually kind of a glam of the pre-chorus, or a chorus. It's kind of a preview of the chorus, it felt like. Then we went into it when most of the instrumentation, and again, dropped back out and got pretty straightforward when the verse came in. Now, I don't know much about this band at all. I didn't look them up or anything, but it sounds like there's multiple singers. And so what's nice about that is each one of them gives their unique performance and abilities based on their instruments. And I caught on to that. That would be like playing two different guitars and stuff. You know, if one guy did a solo with this guitar style and everything, and the guy does the pickup solo with another style. And then they came back in and they readdressed what was happening earlier, which seemed to have been the hook. So I really like that in the song construction and everything. So let's go a little forward and see what else I can pull from this.
That is calm, but sometimes all I think about is you. Late nights in the middle of June. E-waves been faking me out. Can't make you happy or now. You can't fight it, you can't breathe. You say something so loving, but now I gotta let you go.
You saw me kind of freeze with it because I felt in the tempo within I was listening, you know. We get the tempo viscerally. Even if you don't know how to count music, but you know what the beat is. Inherently, when we hear music, we will find ourselves bobbing to a rhythm, even if we don't know that we're doing it. In my case, you know, as a musician and composer, it was already locked in with me. That's what I was expecting, and here it comes. I really appreciated that dead stop too, because there's power in silence. Big lesson in music. Couple things I want to bring up. The bass. I love the bass arrangement. They're doing a lot of half notes and whole note. No whole notes, but like half notes and stuff. Or the quarter notes they're holding down. Doom, doom, and letting it ring out. And that ring out isn't a fade ring out. It seems to be like a bass that just kind of holds its beef. And then into the next one and stuff. And I thought that was really, really cool. It wasn't, had they decided to go dun, 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 would have changed the whole arrangement completely, because the bottom is so important. A lot of times the bottom end of music is less recognizable on the surface, but much more recognizable internally. There's a story about that. I'll tell you guys one day. Then I also noticed too that in the second verse, there's a nice little sequence that's going on with a very soft, another hybrid soft keyboard that I liked, that was keeping, I think it was 16th. It felt like it. I can't recall exactly what the notes were, but I really enjoyed that little space there. And then even when it breaks down, right before this section I just heard, the vocals are really well done. I could feel the emotion in the performance, even though I'm not listening to the lyrics much because I'm trying to get into the actual dynamics and the techniques of from recording to composition, arrangement, musicianship. I like how they're just maneuvering. There's a lot going on there. It's you know, engineering something like this can be complex in the sense that you have so many choices that you can bring this up, take this out, remove this, take this pattern, put it here, then let it glide. I mean, there's a lot going on there. I would have loved to have seen the automation on this in engineering, or, you know, how the tracks may have ended up looking like in the master mix out. So, all right, let's continue this on here. All right.
Sometimes all I think about is you. Late nights in the middle of June. E-waves been faking me out. Can't make you happy or not. Sometimes all I think about is you. Late nights in the middle of June. E-waves been faking me out. Can't make you happy or not.
I like that. That was a really good example of what I was just saying, is when they, you know, in this case, they dropped this all out for us at the very end. That really overwhelming kick had kind of an early, like an early reflection on it and post kind of a sound to it. And then even that little, that little thing that we heard at the very end could very well be a part of the master mix, be one of the many arrangements that are in there that we don't draw attention to, because when it's mixed together, you know, obviously it's supposed to be about delivering a song as a complete body of work so people can enjoy it. But in my head, because I specialize in arrangements and layers and compositions with media composition, you know, film, TV, libraries, blah, blah, blah. I dial into that because it's, a lot of times there's all those particular nuances that I know that comes together in order to bring, for me, a final mix out in something that I'm doing. Something else that I want to bring up before I say aloha to everybody is, in the hook out, the chorus, you know, the melody was great, but what I really enjoyed about it, there was a secondary little arrangement there that was boom, ba, boom, ba, boom, ah. That was really nice because the melody was actually, you know, doing eighth notes and stuff in its rhythmical arrangement of the melody. But this other arrangement here was just being very kind of inconspicuous. But it definitely was a very important part of the arrangement of that. When you go back and listen to that, listen for that. And I think, I mean, it sounds like it's a, you know, once again, a hybrid kind of synth part. But I think it's also there's vocals that are doubling that as well. So anyhow, so thanks for hanging out. I will be, you know, back here throughout the week dropping some more of your favorite music and your suggestions. I want to thank you guys, if maybe some of this music isn't your favorite kind of music, for hanging in here through the journey. I've had the subscribers, our subscriptions been going up. That's fun. I'm never about the numbers, but it's really nice. The comments are great from all around the world, from all of you who have been listening to the videos and going through the experience that I am in this world music kind of channel. And then once again, I do want to say, though, my other channel, if you want to check it out, the link is below there on my main page on YouTube. It's heavy metal. And all the subgenres and rock and all prog rock and all the subgenres there. So you can go check that one out. Anyhow, you guys take care. Have a wonderful day. I'll see you next time around. All right.